Hail, Holy Mother. Sacred Word to the King, who rules heaven and earth forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We celebrate this Mass in honor of our Blessed Mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary. We call to mind our sins and ask our Lord as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, ask the Lord for our pardon and strength, mercy and forgiveness. And confess
the Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have great sin in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do.
Through my fault,
therefore I ask the Blessed Mary,
ever virgin,
all the angels and saints, and the dear brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, Lord God, that we, your servants, may rejoice in the healing health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, may we be set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God called to Adam and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten them from the tree of which I have forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman who you put here with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. was not be allowed to put out his hand to take food from the tree of life also, and thus eat of it and live forever. Beloved, therefore, banish me from the garden of Eden to till the ground from which he had been taken. When he expelled the man, he said to him, east of the garden of Eden, and he stationed the cherubim and the fearing revolving sword to guard the way to the tree of life. The word of the Lord. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Before the mountains that we got to, and the earth and the world were brought forth, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn man back to dust, saying, return, O children of men, for 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night. In every day, O Lord, we have been our refuge. You make an end of them in their sleep, and next morning, they are like the changing grass, which at dawn springs up anew, but by evening wills and fades. In the every day, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Seven loaves. He gave thanks, broke the bread,
purified your fish. He sent a blessing over them. In order then to distribute the corso, the apes came were satisfied. They picked up the fragments left over, 7 baskets. There were about 4,000 people. He dismissed the crowds and got into the boat with his disciples and came to the great but the region of Dalmanutha. The Gospel of the Lord. What do we have in all of these readings, especially the first reading? We heard this. The Garden of Eden, or the story of part of this story, and the downfall of humanity without perseverance, and the victory is also, what do we have? 5 basic points. Number 1, food. Very, very important. One of the basic necessities of anyone. They were forbidden to eat this. But in relation to food, which is basic necessity, what do we have from the perspective of Jesus? Meaning, of course, if they get hungry, we know he is sick. But he didn't stop there. He reminds me of our humanity. And we have to fact that in the case of the universe. One is a bear, from bread alone, but every word comes from the mouth of God. Yes, food is basic necessity. That we need food for everlasting life. Jesus, body and blood, soul and divinity, declaring directly in each one of us, he who eats of my flesh and drinks of my blood shall have life everlasting. 2nd point, marriage. What happened here with the downfall of our spirits? Not no matter that, the problem of divorce. Nothing new. We shrunk from the day of the night. And Jesus, what God unites, let no one divide. How come Moses agreed? Well, and Jesus said, because there are stored in our heart. Third point, not only food and marriage, work. Very, very important, especially in times starting due to the pandemic, people have lost jobs perhaps, even homes. So work is very important. It expresses one's creativity. It expresses one's dignity. In fact, scripture says, he who does not work should not eat. Meaning, we work. That's part of the human dignity. by the very few. That's not the real God. But it's the way it is, and the way it is, and this is happening if we're reading the signs of the times. That's their point. Poor point. Jesus came as a savior. For what? To rescue us from a dim, eternal damnation. Something we heard many, many times. To rescue us from the practices of Satan, of the devil. To save us from the way of sinning. Very, very basic. He gave us one who God has just accepted as a restorer, one word for God, Yeshua. What's that? Savior. Good point. The last one, what's my desire? To make us a saint, like St. Joseph. Then the martyrs and the saints, to make us holy, and hopefully, and blameless, pure, and one of our blameless, and one of our spotless, that are blessed in heaven. Why? Because the book of Revelation says, no, again, no one can enter the kingdom of God with a slight spot and or stain of sin. Basic points in all of this gospel. Meaning, all these points are running against that are helping you to work today. Meaning, we have to conquer as God's word, as the gospel is a counterculture. In a culture where we know that there is a especially the ways of God. Not the way or the ways of God, but the way and the ways of me, myself, and I. Where do you start? With Judaism, with authoritarianism? No. We're not a me. Not you, God, no. We will eat this forbidden fruit. We will make ourselves the center because the devil said, oh, don't worry, you will be like God. And we're talking about the devil. You already know we have a very, very important, very unique 40-day Lenten retreat. I hope you will not just you may not be able to come because you are interested but not available. But at least invite others. Why? Well, if we are about 55% of 848 of this church, we should have a little more than 100. Why not? And if there are people who do not like to be inside, you can say, around this church, whatever, you can still listen to our speakers outside. Very, very important. 40 days, it's a very tough retreat, and you will know it. It's a doing it yourself. Most of it you do it at home. Yes. During the day, in the evening, at work, during maybe there's a strange time there. But we gather here as much as possible every evening. In front of Jesus and body and blood, so we can give you a holy adoration. We pray the rosary, we buy mercy chapel, we listen to our input, we have a blessing, and so on.
porque temos a morar na nossa cidade de Chico, already so many morar sobre ele, que é. So, the mission of being the devil who attempted our first parents, come. What this is not about? Of course, it is a complete prayer of man, but it is tactical training, tactical training. We decide a war. We do strategic tactics and planning how to wage war against Satan. So what's the title? Tactical training for freedom from Satan. Very, very important spiritual battle, the hardest battle ever to be fought. And I put enmity between you and the world, between your seed and my seed, says today's first reading. And Jesus was victorious with us. Our blessed mother was free from the stain of sin. So we look forward to this, that there will be not just for ourselves, for others, for our world, what's happening in the world. Why is this so crucial? Because again, as 40 years back, it would generally take about an hour to cast out demons, in general. Now, have a session of 2 to 3 hours every week. You will have an average of 10 months to 2 years at least. Or 5, 10, 15 years today. That's how Satan is raging today. The devil is real, and Satan never sleeps. We begin this coming Tuesday, by the way. And then, after the Sunday, we'll be with the arms on Sunday. The very first day of the week. Please rise. We continue to pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for bishops of the world, that they will continue in their commitment to be holy and to be a saint, to be a disciple, because we are sent for the mission of Jesus. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for all those old priests and bishops and the faithful for those engaging in other communities in the church. Again, that they will truly be a disciple of Jesus, conscious, deliberate, and intentional, because they are sent for a great harvest, harvest of souls. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for peace in the world, the peace that comes from the Lord, for this we pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who suffer by whatever form of illness or ailment, those who suffer with what kinds of relations, abusive relations, violence, wars, conflicts, divisions, and all that. That all their sacrifices, pains and sufferings, trials and difficulties, that their sacrifice will be one in their redemptive sacrifice in Jesus and the gospel. This we pray to the Lord. We pray for the eternal grace of all those who have been promised, all of their loved ones, relatives and friends, people we know, people who ask us to pray for them, the holy source of our purity, that we're not in our souls, all know what they're not praying for them. We pray for them, eternal grace for them. We pray for the Lord. The rest of God now are our intentions in His Lord's sacrifice and demands. All these heavenly Father, we ask for Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be the Lord, God of all creation, what we have built, we have received. The bread we offer you, food we earn, the work of human hands, and we become God's, the bread. Blessed in the world.
become acceptable to God, we are dying in God. Receive, Lord, we ask the prayers of your people. We the sacrificial offerings that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition we go and answer, no request be made in vain. Especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her and her hymn of praise. For truly, even to our ends, you have done great things, and extended your abundant mercy for many days. When you look to the loveliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the offer of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. To him, those greatest shares and lords of your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus and exultant prayers as we give the name.
Holy.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. In giving thanks, he said a blessing. In giving the chalice, his disciples sang praise. All of you who pray upon me for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross,
amen.
You will, the reason such hospitals shall grant that we are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and give the restored spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, your spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Myron, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through humility and meaning, O God, almighty Father, give it the hand of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
As Savior's commandment and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us from we pray from every evil and gracious give our peace in the days. That by the help of your mercy, we may be always delivered from sin and saved from all distress, as we await a blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, He said in your mind, He said in you, look not at our sins, but the faith of your church. Embrace your wonder, peace, and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. On this day, we glorious behind the moon, miserere nobis. On this day, Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are the Lord and Savior. Communion unto one. Behold the womb of the Virgin Mary, which bore the Son of the Eternal Father. Please be seated.
that we who rejoice in the commemorating of the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve her with the hidden mystery of our redemption. As we continue to be one in His holiness, as we are sent on His mission.